Bonjour, bienvenue à Language Place et aujourd'hui on va voir comment conjuguer les verbes au passé composé. Passé composé can be compared to past tense in English. I'm sure you all know past tense in English. I ate, I danced, I stole. Past tense. Passé composé is past tense in English. Now, as the name implies, composé. It is composed of two different verbs. Passé composé is a tense composed of two different verbs. We have le verbe auxiliaire et le verbe principal. Le verbe auxiliaire, which means auxiliary verb, and the major verb, the main verb, which is verb principal. Now, I know you know about the verb auxiliaire in French. We've treated it before. The two major auxiliary verbs we have in French are avoir and être. Et means and. Avoir et être. Avoir et être. Avoir means to have. Avoir veut dire to have. Et être veut dire to be. Avoir veut dire to have. Et être means to be. Avoir et être are the two auxiliary verbs we have in French. Now, when do you know which to use? When you want to say the past tense of a particular verb. Like I said, there are two auxiliary verbs in French, avoir and être. When do we use avoir to say past tense? When do we use être? For now, keep in mind that for more than 85% of French verbs, we use avoir to express the passé composé, that is, the past tense. So, in this class, we are going to be using avoir. For most verbs in French, we use avoir to express the passé composé. Now, remember, to conjugate avoir in present tense, that is, présent de l'indicatif, on dit j'ai, tu as, il a, elle a, nous avons, vous avez, ils ont, et elles ont. Nous avons, vous avez, ils ont et elles ont. Très bien. Now, verbe principal. Verbe principal. What does verbe principal mean? Verbe principal means the main verb. The main verb. Et n'oubliez pas, we said verbs in French are divided into three groups. We have the first group verbs, the second group verbs, and the third group verbs. The first group verbs end with ER and they are regular. The first group verbs end with ER and they are regular. The second group verbs end with UR, with IR, and they are also regular. The first group verbs end with ER and they are regular. The second group verbs end with IR and they are also regular. While the third group verbs, they are my favorites. They can have any ending. They can end with ER, IR, OIR, DRE, CRE, and so on and so forth. Ça va? Bon. So let's proceed to passé composé. Passé composé. Passé composé. Let's take my favorite verb. Manger. Manger means to eat. Manger means to eat. Manger means to eat. Now, remember, I said to conjugate passé composé of a verb in French, you take the auxiliary verb first, which will be avoir. Now, the auxiliary verb will be conjugated in present tense. So, this will start with j'ai. It will be conjugated in present tense. J'ai. Now, manger becomes manger. This happens for all first group verbs. All first group verbs in passé composé change to this form. That is, the ER changes to E accent aigu. Now, for you ate or you have eaten, tu as, the same thing, manger. Now for he ate or he has eaten, il a the same thing, manger. Now for she ate or she has eaten, elle a and the same thing, manger. J'ai mangé, tu as mangé, il a mangé, elle a mangé. Now for nous, we ate or we have eaten. That becomes nous avons, and you change it to manger again. Manger. Nous avons mangé. You see why first group verbs are regular? They follow irregular pattern also. Nous avons mangé. Now for vous, vous avez mangé. Vous avez mangé. Now for il ou elle, we say, let's take it here. For il ou elle, we say, ils ont mangé. Ils ont mangé. Ils ont mangé. And for elle, elles ont mangé. Elles ont mangé. This is the format for first group verbs. That is, verbs that end with er and follow a regular pattern of conjugation. Let's see other verbs. Another verb I like. Other verbs. Other first group verbs. First group verbs. For example, we have voler. Voler. Guess what? Voler means to steal. To steal. To steal. Now, if I want to say I stole in French, I use passé composé. That is the tense. Passé composé can be compared to past tense in English. Now, to say I stole, remember I said we use the auxiliary verb and the verb itself. Donc, j'ai, which is the auxiliary verb. Remember, I said the ER changes to E accent aigu. So that becomes J'ai volé. Now for you stole, remember, tu as the same thing. Tu as volé. For he stole, il a the same thing. Il a volé. Now for she stole, elle a volé. Elle a volé. Now for we stole, nous avons volé. Ça va? For you stole, vous avez volé. Vous avez volé. For they stole, the same thing. Ils ont volé et elles ont volé. Très bien. Ah, I stole, j'ai volé. You stole, tu as volé. He stole, il a volé. She stole, elle a volé. We stole, nous avons volé. You stole, vous avez volé. They stole, ils ont volé. Elles ont volé. So if I want to say I stole the pen. I stole the meat. I stole the meat. That becomes j'ai volé. The meat in French becomes j'ai volé la viande. I stole the meat. J'ai volé la viande. If I want to say he stole the pen, that becomes il a volé le stylo. Il a volé le stylo. Remember, er verbs change to e accent aigu. That is the key behind the conjugation in passé composé. Let's see the last verb for today. The last verb for today. Très bien. Apprécier. Apprécier means to appreciate. Apprécier means to appreciate. Remember the auxiliary verb first, than the major verb. Now, j'ai appris, and this changes to accent aigu. J'ai apprécié, tu as apprécié, tu as apprécié, il a apprécié, il a apprécié, elle a apprécié, elle a apprécié. Très bien. Nous avons apprécié, nous avons apprécié. Vous avez apprécié, vous avez apprécié. Très bien. Vous avez apprécié. Et ils ont apprécié, ils ont apprécié. Et elles ont apprécié. Voilà. Là, c'est la fin pour les verbes du premier groupe conjugués au passé composé. Et dans la prochaine classe, on va continuer avec les verbes du deuxième groupe. Merci et à la prochaine.